If you don't particularly enjoy using a terminal program to do basic things and you need to minify images often enough, I'm happy to introduce you to Curtail. A while ago, a French developer, Hugo Posnick, created a tiny application called Curtail that is pretty much a simplistic user interface for optipng, pngquant and jpegoptim. I saw Garrett Lesage mention that to a fellow Red Hat designer Maureen Duffy on Twitter, so thanks to you both. You can install Curtail from Flathub or you can build it yourself, which is a bit of exaggeration because it's just running Meson and Ninja or Python code. Now, this is almost everything there is to see in this program. It's just foolproof, it's what you probably have grown to see in online services like tinyping.com. Basically, you select whether you want compression to be lossy or lossless and then you drag and drop files onto the main window. Then they automatically get compressed and you can see here names of files, old size, new size and how much you saved in percents. Once compression is done, you can click the left arrow button here to go back to the main view. Curtail does have some options. Go to the header bar, click the three dots button and choose preferences. You can enable or disable the preservation of metadata, which you don't need for things like iconspot, probably won't for photos. You can choose whether you want to overwrite original images or create new ones, in which case you also need to specify the text that will be appended to the base file name. Curtail suggests this hyphen min text by default, which sounds like a reasonable default. You can also force Curtail to use a dark version of the user interface theme, if there is one. Now, compression and advanced pages both have options for setting compression level. The form one is for lossy compression of PNG and JPEG, and the latter one has a setting for lossless PNG compression that is basically a trade-off between making smaller files and compressing faster. And now that is really all there is to see here. It's a nice little app, it does one job and it does it well. It is entirely possible that adding some more compression settings would be helpful. So if you feel that way, the project has a bug tracker on GitHub for feature requests. Thank you for watching and see you soon.